I'm ready.
I'm ready.
I'm ready. Seems like you're ready for me.
Of course, I'm always ready.
This is what we call the tease. We're talking to Omari Banks.
Well, it's a pleasure to be here in St. Kitts. This is my first time for the music festival, but I've been coming to St. Kitts for a very long time from a little boy. Had a lot of great memories here over the years, and it's always a pleasure to come back again and have a great time.
It's just amazing that finally I had to come all the way to St. Kitts to finally get to meet Omari Banks.
Well, it's a pleasure to meet you too, Ephraim. Big up to yourself for making this trip here, and now you just need to fulfill on your word and do as they say and take me back.
Take you back? How far do you want me to take you back?
You tell me.
And you will go.
Of course.
What make you such a, not just a performer or an artist? Because I'm hearing not just about you performing, singing. I heard you was involved in some kind of sport. For the viewers who don't know about you, can you tell me a little about that?
So, yeah, I'm the first Anguillan, first and only Anguillan to represent, to play cricket for the West Indies. I like to boast myself that my last match I played for the West Indies, I was man of the match, which is true. I was nominated for World Young Cricket of the Year by Wisden Magazine. One of the nominees, myself, Graham Smith and James Anderson, back in 2003. And I played professionally in England for Somerset as well. But had a great time doing what I love. At the time, it was cricket. That was my obsession, my focus, my passion. But I always had the talent and I always had a passion as well for music. And it's always great to follow. I always tell my kids, I always tell myself even to continue to follow my passions and do what I love. And me performing and doing music is just a representative of where my focus and where my passions lie.
So what can we expect from you coming to New York? Because I know after leaving St. Kitts and seeing you and watching you on stage tonight, what left for New York? Is there more energy left in you?
Yeah, there's a lot more energy left in me. I'm really excited to come over to New York. I'm planning on coming over to do a show in the a run between Maryland. I have a show in Maryland on the 31st of August, and we're going to put together a little run between New York and Maryland around that time. I always have a great time when I come over there. I've got a lot of friends, family. You know, New York is like the Caribbean in some places. So I'm looking forward to come over, promoting my new music, my new single, which is Half Full, Half Empty, as well as doing a few shows for the people over there.
Half full or half empty, every day we got to live and count the blessings. Okay. Let them talk, them could never ever stop me. All the criticism can't break this rasta, baby. Them would grudge if it been hard working. Them even grudge me face what me mommy and me daddy give. But me not study about them for long. We keep the message positive. The youth, we give them inspiration. I know who's going to help me for those I care. The others I can't see. Half full or half empty. Alright. Every day we got to live and count the blessings. Free up your mind, forget about the envy. Riding through this life, it's all about how you see things. Half full or half empty.